Hello everyone, Nemain here. In this video I'm gonna show you how you can get arcdps and ReShade to work alongside each other. So let's go! First of all, we're gonna install arcdps. So visit the deltaconnected.com/arcdps page, scroll to the very bottom and click the Here button. On the next page, select the d3d11.dll file and download it. Since I've been using arcdps in the past and have downloaded it a few times, my file might be called a little different than yours. Just make sure you rename it or make sure that the file finally is called d3d11.dll. You can leave the file in the root folder for now, we're gonna move it later though. After putting your arcdps file in the root folder, we will start Guild Wars 2. That's so the add-ons folder gets created in the background. As you can see, we now have the add-ons folder at the very top. For the next step, we want to download ReShade. And be sure to download the one with full add-on support. The advantage for the full add-on support version is that the depth blur, for example, and your effects stay if you are moving with your character, for example, for video edits or in general. I have already downloaded the file, so I'm gonna open it from my downloads folder. Before the installer starts, it will tell you that the ReShade with add-on support is only intended for single-player games. Of course, install this at your own risk. I have been playing Guild Wars at this point for I think about 4 or 5 years. I have used this since pretty much the beginning, ReShade in general, and also the one with add-on support. I have never had any issues. I don't know of any people in the community that do have issues or had bans or restrictions or anything. So yeah, it's pretty safe to use, but take it with a grain of salt. Just a little disclaimer. After having read the warning, click on OK and select the Browse button. Select your Guild Wars file and press Open. Click Next and select DX11. If you have a preset to install, you can do that here. If not, then just skip this step. As for the effects, I'm just gonna check all here. If you have any special effects that you do not want, this is the place to uncheck them. This next step is super important, so follow this closely. We are going to take the d3d11.dll from the arcdps file and put it in the bin64 folder. Click your bin64 folder and move the d3d11.dll to the cef folder. Rename the file that you just dropped there to dxgi.dll. You can double check by hovering over the file if it still says arcdps for the file description. Now go back to your root folder where your Guild Wars 2 is installed and rename the dxgy.dll, which is from ReShade, to d3d11.dll. So we're basically reversing the file names. Now let's start up Guild Wars and see if it worked. Spoiler alert, it did. Don't be alarmed about the error messages that you see from arcdps. We had a patch just a few days ago and the arcdps creator is on holidays. Well deserved, by the way. So you will probably, hopefully, not get this warning since there will be a patch coming. As you can see, we have the arcdps overlay as well as the ReShade overlay at the very top. At the very beginning, there is obviously no filter on your game because you just freshly installed ReShade and you will have to select your preset or the filters that you want after. I'm just gonna quickly check some shaders to prove that ReShade is working as it should. Almost as it should, but we'll get to that in a minute. In the list here, you might see some folders that you do not have. That is because I have some presets and shaders saved on my computer. To show you guys how to get the depth of field working, because that is broken since a very long time. I don't even know if it was like that since the beginning. I'm just gonna load my own preset, shameless plug, that I made a while back. I'm gonna link it down in the description if you're interested. It is a very subtle preset. I basically only have a little sharpener on there and a little color correction because I don't like my game to be overly saturated. There's a multitude of filters that you can apply to get a depth of field or a blur effect. My personal favorite one is the, I hope I'm gonna pronounce this correctly, Quint ADOF effect by Marty McFly. So I'm gonna select this filter to show you guys how to get it to work. You can see now that my character started to get blurry, as well as the foreground of my game, which is basically the exact opposite of what I want, because I want to have the background blurry and obviously not my own character. And we're gonna fix that in a minute. I'm gonna pull this up a little bit so you guys can see it a little better. Here comes the very important step. You wanna click on Edit Global Preprocessor Definitions. In this little submenu, you have the option ReShade Depth Input is Reversed, which is after the installation set to 1. We will change this and put in a 0. I'm just gonna quickly show you how to play with the depth of field effect if you are a new user. I personally prefer to disable the autofocus for my screenshots, but that is of course up to you. The two options that I use most frequently is the manual focus depth and the hyperfocal depth distance. In my opinion, these are the two options that make the most difference in your game when it comes to blur. If you are too lazy or don't have the time to go through all these options manually, you can also just copy the numbers that you will see on my screen if you are happy with how it looks. You might have seen that there is a little FPS counter at the very top right. If you want to get rid of that, go to the Settings tab. And since I'm a professional, you can clearly not see this on my screen because of my overlay. All right, there we go. Disable the Show FPS checkbox and it will be gone. That's it already. And if you have any more questions, don't hesitate to write it in the comments below. I wish you a lot of fun fiddling around with ReShade and see you next time. Bye bye.